Welcome to the Noonday Meditation with Wayne Vernon.
St. John chapter 14, 28 to 31. You have heard me say, I am going away, and I am coming back to you. If you loved me, you would be glad that I am going to my Father, for the Father is greater than I. I have told you now, before it happens, so that when it does happen, you will believe. John chapter 14 to 17 records what is called the farewell discourse of our Lord. Jesus gives this discourse to his disciples at the end of the Last Supper on the night prior to his crucifixion at the hands of the Roman authorities. A critical component of the discourse is our Lord's announcement of his departure to his disciples. Understandably, this was a rather emotional time for those who had journeyed with him for 3 years. But our Lord's announcement was accompanied by an admonition and assurance. Here Jesus assures his disciples of his departure, that it is not a terminal transaction. So in the verse 28, he said, I am going away. I am coming back to you. The promise of his return was meant to be a consolation for his followers. In addition, Jesus assured his disciples that based on his relationship with them, his departure should not be viewed as a sad thing. In fact, it was to be understood as a good thing, because this was a critical portion of the redemptive mission. If you love me, Jesus said, you would be glad that I'm going to the Father, for the Father is greater than I. You see, perfect love eliminates fear. It gives confidence. But our Lord understands the human frailty, and therefore he declares, I have told you now before it happens, so that when it does happen, you will believe. It will be confirmation that my word is authentic. In the final analysis, our Lord, in his admonition, declares, I will not speak with you much longer, for the prince of this world is coming and has no hold on me. But the world must learn that I love the Father, and I do exactly what my Father has commanded me. Satan, being fully aware of his defeat, remains persistent nonetheless. Jesus, however, remains resolute that he will obey his Father's will, demonstrating to the world that he loves his Father. One writer puts it this way: if we obey Jesus and align ourselves closely with God's purposes, Satan would have no power over us. And this is what Jesus tried to help his disciples to understand. The watching world would recognize Jesus' love for his Father because of his obedience to his Father. And the watching world is going to judge our love for the Father because of our obedience to him. We've been reiterating that all of last week, and we remind you of it today. Be assured that God is with you today. You are not alone. And if you submit to the promises of God and demonstrate your love for him, the watching world will recognize. Should you need further instructions in these matters, please feel free to text the number 647-309-7302. Should you desire to surrender your life to the Lord Jesus Christ, please text the word salvation to this number as well. We continue to invite you to join us for our 50th convention, Easter Convention, coming up on April 15. We look forward to having you and your family and friends and all those in your social network. Our speakers include Dr. Tim Hill, our international overseer, Dr. Keith Ivester, our national overseer, Dr. Lennox Walker, our regional overseer, and others. We're going to be blessed by Psalmist Latoya Hall Downer, who is going to be with us for this convention. We invite you to be there. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you all. Amen.
Thank you for listening to the Noonday Meditation with Pastor Wayne Vernon. Please forward this study to your friends, your relatives, associates, neighbors, and all those persons in your social network. If you have a prayer request, please feel free to communicate with us, and we will commit to supporting you in prayer. Until we meet again tomorrow, Shalom.